Hey all, and welcome to another one. Okay, so today we're going to show you how to connect your Hikvision DVR or NVR to the internet, so you'll be able to go online and then download the app and view your lovely CCTV on your phone. Okay, so I'm going to break this video down into three quick parts, and the first part is in front of you is going to be connecting your DVR physically. The second part is we're going to go onto your recorder and then do a couple of settings, and then the third part is if you're still showing offline, what to do then. Okay, so right now get your recorder. At the back of the recorder you have an RJ45 port. Connect that via a cable or power line adapter to your internet router. Okay, pretty straightforward. If you don't know what a power line adapter is, it's a very handy device. It will use your power electricity grid in your house to use a signal. So for example, you have your recorder in your loft and your DVR is obviously plugged in there somewhere, just plug in a power line next to that, and then next to your internet router, because that will be plugged in as well, plug another power line adapter in there, and then you can connect your DVR to your router. Essentially, it's essentially wireless. Okay, so that's a great option if you can't run a cable, but we definitely recommend running a cable. Okay, so once you've done that, now go on to your DVR. We're going to go set a couple of settings on there. Okay, I'll see you in a sec. All right, guys, so we're on our DVR now. Now we have to change a couple of settings in order to get our DVR online. Okay, so for this, we go to configuration. Okay, I know some DVR's menus do look different, but just look for the network section. Okay, every DVR will have a network section, and the first thing we're going to do is under the first menu that comes up, TCP/IP. okay, so we need to enable something called DHCP. Now if you've never heard of it and had no idea what it is, make sure it's enabled. Okay, so it's going to basically link to your router. Okay, it's going to give it a local IP address. So we've enabled DHCP, we just have to click on apply. Okay, now it's given it an IP address. Okay, so this is step one, what you have to do, and step two is we're going to go to platform access. Okay, so quickly, just regarding DHCP, most new recorders should have this enabled. Maybe on older ones it didn't come enabled, but recently they all come enabled. Okay, so now we're going to go to platform access. So most DVRs, like I said, look for this section, platform access. It might be under advanced or something like that, tab on under network, or sometimes it's called hik-connect or something like that. Okay, so now we find this tab, and as you see, connection status offline. Okay, that means we cannot add the app to it right now. So we're going to click on enable, click on okay. Okay, we're going to give it a verification code. Okay, so this can be anything you want. Okay, it's going to ask you for this code when you log onto the app. All right, so I'm just going to do 123456, confirm. That's our verification code. Remember that for later when you add the app, but you can always change it. And now one more little important thing, bind status, no. Okay, so if you just bought a brand new DVR, it should say no here. Okay, that means no one's ever used it before. If you're inheriting an old DVR, the chances are this might say yes, or later on when you try to add the app, you might not even have this feature here. It might just say, oh, this recorder is already bound to another device. Don't worry, guys, we've got this sorted for you. Check the link below and I'll show you how to unbind it. Okay, so now we've enabled it, we put a verification code in, now click on apply. All right, so now you just got to give it a few seconds and it will go online, or you could just go to one tab and then come back. And now we go, boom, it's online, guys. Okay, simple as that. So now follow the link in the description below. So we've got a couple of videos on how to get the app. We've got a quick one and a long one, depending on how much time you have. So I recommend checking them out now, how to get the app. But that's it for this bit. If you're online, you're good. If not, if you're still seeing offline, then I'm afraid, carry on watching. Okay, so if you're still watching this part, unfortunately, then you're still offline. So I've been doing this job for a long time, guys. I've dealt with a lot of installers saying it's offline, it's not working, it's faulty, this or that. They bring it to our shop, we plug it in, and it works, okay? So almost all the time, it is a router issue, okay? If you've got some sort of complex firewall or router settings or an unusual setup, you know, this is what is blocking it. If you have a regular home router and you've never changed any settings in your life and everything else works, okay, it can be tough to explain, but it is possible. But if you're 100% sure that it's not your router, then please check all your connections and cables. I'm telling you, there's very rarely ever a faulty DVR or NVR that is faulty in the way that it won't go online. Okay, there's no magic button or magic settings you could do. It just goes online. Okay, just like when you plug in a PC to the internet through a cable, you know, it just goes online and it figures it out. Okay, so check out your router settings, check all your cables and connections, and you know, even take your DVR to a friend's house, just plug it in, see if you can get online. Okay, and if you're really still pulling your hair out, then try defaulting the unit and updating the firmware. Okay, I'll leave a link below how to do those things, but it could help. Okay, so thanks for watching, guys. Now I'm gonna leave a link here so you can see the app video. Now hopefully you've gone online, but I know most people here might be offline still and not ready for that video just yet, but I've got a couple of good ones, so check them out. And thanks for watching. And this video did help. Don't forget to like, because it does help the algorithm. So cheers for that. All right, have a good one. Catch you in the next one.